When contemplating astrobiology and the broad idea of consciousness in the universe, there are really two ways to think about it. The first is the standard view of life arising on a world through chemistry, and then evolution taking over and allowing, or not allowing, life to move towards complexity. But there actually is another option for the genesis of life, or consciousness, to arise independently of evolution or even biochemistry. The factors that define this hypothetical alternate option for life are time and the size of the universe rather than biochemistry. Unfortunately, we don't actually know how big the universe really is. We may never be able to know. We can only know about the observable universe, that which is close enough for us to see. But that's not all of it. Some fraction of the universe is simply too far away to be seen. We don't know how large of a fraction that is. There comes a point where there is simply too much expanding space between you and another part of the universe to allow for light traveling at a finite speed to ever reach you. So how much of the universe lies beyond our view? We have no idea. It could be a small amount, a large amount, or even infinity. The latter has huge ramifications. If infinite, all possible things will eventually happen, including nearly exact copies of Earth and us. Think infinite Earths and infinite you, varying in minor details. But what's particularly relevant here is that the more universe you have, and the more time you have, the odds for chance occurrences rises. In an infinite universe, chance occurrences are bound to happen, including life arising from spontaneous arrangements of atoms rather than from a chemical process. In other words, by pure chance, a bacterium could appear from nothing, or more. This idea relates to a thought experiment known as a Boltzmann brain, first advanced by physicist Ludwig Boltzmann in 1896. He suggested that if you wait a long enough time, and I mean a seriously long time, far longer than the current age of the universe, eventually by sheer chance, atoms could assemble into a conscious brain, either aware or completely unaware of the universe around it. This can scale up. Again, with enough time in an infinite universe, a giant superintelligent supercomputer complete with a power source could spontaneously occur and start thinking in the same way that if you have a group of monkeys typing on typewriters, given enough time, one of them will type out the complete works of Shakespeare perfectly. It may take trillions of years, but it will, purely by chance, eventually happen. But time is a tricky thing in that we don't know how much time is left for this universe. Some think that the proton will eventually decay. If so, there may not be enough time for a Boltzmann brain scenario to occur in a finite universe. Then again, in an infinite universe, it may well have already occurred, or even must have occurred. The implications of an infinite universe is probably the most mind-boggling thing that I know of, and while this is entirely sci-fi speculation on my part, I wonder if a Boltzmann brain supercomputer is out there somewhere in infinity that came into existence already simulating a universe of its own, complete with consciousnesses existing within it in a simulated reality, forever cosmic fever dreams, wholly unaware of their true nature. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently spooked by my revisit to simulation theory. As I think Freud said, sometimes a cigar is just a cigar, and it's my bet that the universe is just one big fat cigar. Call it cigar theory. And since nothing lasts forever, someday, like it or not, we're going to get smoked one way or another. On that note, check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.